Blackstone Audio presents Goodbye to the Dead, a Jonathan Stride novel by Brian Freeman. This book is read by Joe Barrett. For Marcia. We are healed of a suffering only by experiencing it to the full. Marcel Proust. Prologue. The Present. Serena spotted the Grand Am parked half a block from the Duluth bar. Someone was waiting inside the car. Mosquitoes clouded in front of the headlights. The trumpets of a Russian symphony, something loud and mournful by Shostakovich, blared through the vehicle's open windows. Serena smelled acrid, roll-your-own-cigarette smoke drifting toward her with the spitting rain. Beyond the car, through the haze, she saw the milky lights of the bridge arching across the harbor. Only the two of them haunted the late-night darkness of the summer street, herself and the stranger behind the wheel of the Grand Am. She couldn't see the driver, but it didn't matter who was inside. Not yet. She was here for someone else. This was an industrial area on the east end of Raleigh Street, not far from the coal docks and the paper mill. Power lines sizzled overhead. The ground under her feet shook with the passage of a southbound train. She made sure her Mustang was locked, with her Glock securely inside the glove compartment, and then she crossed the wet street to the Grizzly Bear Bar. It was a dive with no windows and an apartment overhead for the owner. Cat was inside. Serena felt guilty about putting tracking software on the teenager's phone, but she'd learned quickly that Cat's sweet face didn't mean she could be trusted. When she pulled open the door of the bar, a sweaty, beery smell tumbled outside. She heard drunken voices shouting in languages she didn't understand, and the twang of a George Strait song on the jukebox. Big men lined up too deep at the bar and played poker at wooden tables. Inside, she scanned the faces, looking for Cat. She spied her near a table at the far wall, standing shoulder to shoulder with an older girl, both of them head down over smartphones. The two made an unlikely pair. Cat was a classic beauty, with tumbling chestnut hair and a sculpted Hispanic face. Her skinny companion had dyed orange spikes peeking out from under a wool cap, and her ivory face was studded with piercings. Serena keyed a text into her own phone and sent it. "Look up." Cat's face shot upward as she got the message. Her eyes widened, and Serena read the girl's lips. "Oh, shit." Cat whispered urgently into her friend's ear. Serena saw the other girl study her like a scientist peering into the business end of a microscope. The skinny girl wore a low-cut mesh shirt over a black bra and a jean skirt that ended mid-thigh. She picked up a drinks tray, she was a waitress, and gave Serena a smirk as she strolled to the bar, leaving Cat by herself. Serena joined Cat at the cocktail table where she was standing. The girl's smile had vanished, and so had all of her adultness. Teenagers drifted so easily between maturity and innocence. Cat was a child again, but she was also a child who was 5 months pregnant. "I'm really sorry," Cat began, but Serena cut her off. "Save it. I'm not interested in apologies." She stopped herself before saying anything more that she'd regret. She was too angry even to look at Cat. Instead, by habit, she surveyed the people in the bar. It was a rough crowd, not a hangout for college kids and middle-class tourists like the bars in Canal Park. Hardened sailors came to the Grizzly Bear off the cargo boats, making up for dry days on the lake with plenty of booze. She heard raspy laughter and arguments that would spill over into fights. The bare, muscled forearms of the drinkers were covered in cuts and scars, and the men left greasy fingerprints on dozens of empty beer bottles. In the opposite corner of the bar, Serena noticed a woman who didn't fit in with the others. The woman sat by herself, a nervous smile on her round face. Her long blonde hair, parted in the middle, hung down like limp spaghetti. She had an all-American look, with blue eyes and young skin, like a cheerleader plucked from a college yearbook. Maybe 22. She kept checking a phone on the table in front of her, and her stare shot to the bar door every time it opened. Something about the woman set off alarm bells in Serena's head. This was a bad place for her. She wanted to go over and ask, "Why are you here?" She didn't, because that was the question she needed to ask Kat. "Why are you here, Kat?"
"I wanted to go somewhere. I'm bored."
That's not an answer.
"Anna works here," Kat said. "She and I know the owner."
Kat nodded at the waitress who'd been with her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.